singing majesty. Majesty, your grace has found me just as I am, empty hand but love in my hands. We're singing
majesty.
We're singing
Sama, Hodaga Yesu Sama.
Sama,
Hodaga Yesu Sama. Sama, Modaga Yesu Sama. Just like you are the great God. You are God. You are not just big. You are not just like you are the great God. You are God.
You are God. Oh,
Holy hands together for Jesus, the King of Kings, the I Am That I Am, the Lion of the Tribe of Judah. Celebrate His presence this morning. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are all welcome to God's presence and to this very special occasion of the consecration of God's servants who will take over and to coordinate the affairs of this ministry. I welcome you once again in Jesus' name. So let's coordinate ourselves so that there will be no rowdiness. I believe that you all, as many as should have, already have the programs in their hands. So I believe there will be order and we will follow it as much as possible. And when you are given the time to do whatever function, you will just do it as snappy as possible to the glory of God. So at this point, I would like us to all rise to our feet as we take the opening prayer. Our Father in the Lord, Reverend Dr. Gbenga Olodude, will take that. Please, let's rise to our feet.
I greet the chairman of PFN and all the ministers in the house. in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want us all to know that this is not a political gathering. It's a spiritual one. And God will reach us as we respect Him. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we are grateful because you made this day possible. We are here in your name. Your name is Emmanuel. God with us. So we acknowledge your presence here. Let everyone be overpowered by your presence. Let everyone be overcome with your presence. Let everyone be conscious of your presence. Let there be reference for your holy name. Let everything that shall be done here be done by you and through you and to your glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, every contrary spirit we bind and we banish from here. In the name of Jesus Christ, let God be glorified. Let Jesus take preeminence. In Jesus Christ's name we decree. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we're going to invite the choir for the praise and worship session. I think you should remain standing so that we can take the praise and worship session. Choir.
Hallelujah. Let's be on our feet. Demons tremble at your presence. What a mighty God you are. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Everything written about you is great. Sing, demons tremble at your presence.
Demons tremble at your presence.
What a mighty God you are.
What a mighty God you are.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Everything.
Everything written about you is great.
Sweet demons tremble.
those hands, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Clap those hands. Wakorie, wakorie, wakorie again. The Lord, wave your hands up. Are you ready to praise the Lord? Walk away, walk away, walk away again. Walk away. Abba, 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 Abba. Everybody.
name Jehovah, oh my name.
I need Jehovah,
Jehovah turns my life around. He turns my life around. He makes a way where there is no way. Jehovah has a final solution. Turns your life around. Jehovah turns your life around. He makes your way where there is no way. Jehovah has the final say.
Turns my life around. Jehovah has the final say.
Some of you are just looking at me dancing. Hallelujah. Some of you are just looking at me dancing. Listen, people just say, people they ask me say, now wait till they make me dance. Some of you, okay, this is what we do now. Look to your neighbor's eyes. Look to your neighbor's eyes. Tell your neighbor, I dance. I just tell you, say, not Jesus. All right, let's practice it now.
I just tell you, say,
Excuse me, that situation, that problem that you are facing, I want to ask you something. I say, who has the final say? Let me ask you. Are you ready? Are you sure? No. Some of you are not sure. Are you sure? I say, who has the final say? Let's see. Okay, if Jehovah has the final say, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Abba, you dance now. Hallelujah. I say, who has the final say? Let's see. Jehovah calls my life around.
In 1:6:1:6.
Thank God for the much progress that we have made. At this point, we want to recognize the presence of God's servants who are here with us today. But I have a very long list. If I have to call all the names, I think it will last longer than the time we will use to take the sermon. So permit me to use the authority vested in me today to adjust that So I'll just welcome our PFN senior officials and ministers who are outside, who came from outside Adamawa State.
Ana ya ta kuma baya na shi shugabana da su costa da kuma duka masu hidima wanda sun zo daga waje.
So help me welcome this morning our father in the Lord, the Northeast Zonal Vice President of the PFN, in the person of Reverend Chris Busari and his wife. You are welcome, sir. And we have the privilege today of having the state PFN chairman with us, who also will be doing the consecration, in the presence of Reverend Dr. Jaffet Onwaso. And next to him is Reverend Benga Olodude, who is the vice chairman of PFN. Thank you, sir, for coming. We also have Reverend Papa Jalo, who is the secretary.
And
very shortly, he'll be bringing the word to us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, to welcome our people from our friends and ministries of this friend from outside Adamawa State, I have Pastor Mrs. Afiniki John, Glorious Rema Bible Church, Jos. God bless you, ma'am. Thank you for traveling all the way to Yola. And I also have Pastor Ado Adams, our father's Global Harvest, Gombe. I hope I got it right. Please pardon me if I didn't get it correctly. And then we also have Reverend Zephaniah Jala from Revelation House International, Jos. Thank you all for coming today. The Lord bless and increase you. And to the rest of us, ministers of this ministry from outside Yola, and all our friends who have come to grace this occasion, you're already in your place of loyalty. And the Lord will reward your sacrifice of love in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So every minister, you are welcome. We recognize you and we know that you are very important. The Lord bless you. So at this point, let's prepare our hearts and trust God for your word this morning. As we have God's servant to us in the next few minutes, Reverend Papa Jalo.
Hallelujah. I greet you all in Jesus' name. What an honor, what a privilege for me to stand before you this morning to share just a little in the space of about 15 to 20 minutes before we go. I go and sit down and then the consecration proper takes place. Thank you, sir, my chairman. Thank you very much for the opportunity given to me. The vice chairman, you've already been welcome, and every other official of the PFM and all the pastors, God bless you in Jesus' name. I want to especially welcome my assistant secretary who does the work when I'm not around and when I'm even around. Stand up, let them see you. I don't have her. Thank you. That's it. We're wearing almost the same shirt. You're welcome, sir. Thank you. Tonight, start timing me from now. This morning. But for the preacher, he does not have to this morning. Always tonight. Just like the soldier, tonight. Morning. So, time me from now. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this moment. We are asking for the penetration of your word into our lives. Thank you for hearing us in Jesus' name. Amen. Please time me. Hebrews 5 and number 4. Hebrews chapter number 5 and number 4. The Bible says, and no man taketh this honor unto himself, but he that is called of God, as was Aaron. Everybody say honor. Everybody say called. Everybody say no man. The Bible says no man. In other words, as great as man is, as wonderful as man is, as blessed as man is, he has no authority when it comes to the call of God. In other words, the authority for the call of God in the life of a man is vested only in God. It is only God that can call a man into such a work as he has desired, as he has planned, as he has arranged. And the Bible says, even if man should usurp this authority, he has no authority to do it. When a man is called, you're not called by another man. You are called by the God who knows you better than any man that could ever align with you or agree or confirm your calling. No man, no matter how graced, no man, no matter how old, no man, no matter how intelligent he is not qualified to call you for the work of God. It is God himself that calls to do the work of God. This honor that no man is qualified to bestow on another man, this respect, this veneration, this calling, this
selected together, all of us, to confirm an honor that is done to one of us by God himself. It is not an honor that we just bestow on her, but we are gathered in the consecration exercise to confirm what God has done in her life. Therefore, there is something you must understand and know. Number one, there are three kinds of calling and more. Number one, call to salvation, which has to do with your redemption. That's the first calling. We come into Christ via salvation. You receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. It's a call. It's not everyone that can come unless the Spirit draws him. Unless you call into it, you can't come in. That's the first call. Second call, apart from you being called into Christ, you are called into his service or his work, which is what you do within the house of God. Service, ministerial service, whatever it is, we are called into that. Secondly, the third one, whether you are born again, you're called into the church, to Christ, or you're called into doing one thing or the other or not, this final call will dawn on you. That's the call of death. If Jesus tarries, none of us will survive here. If the rapture does not happen, we will all die. Now hear me, that call, you have no choice. The first call, you have a choice either to receive or not to receive. The second, you have a choice either to do the work or not to do the work. But the third, you have no choice, because it is appointed unto man to die once, and after that, the judgment. Friends, brothers and sisters, if you call of God, therefore, you will know that you are chosen. That's what the Bible says in John 15:16. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. You are chosen. You are called. You are honored. You are privileged. You are respected. You are placed in a place, a high office of distinction. Such an honor no man can confer to you. It's only God that can give you that kind of honor. And that is what we've come to witness today. 2 Timothy 1:9 says, you are called to his purpose. You are chosen. You are called. You are selected from amongst wherever, however. Now you are called to fulfill purpose. To fulfill purpose. The purpose of God for my life is not the purpose of God for your life. But the end result of every purpose is at the end of it all that Jesus is glorified. The work is done. Lives are touched. Lives are helped. And people are properly positioned to serve God in truth and in spirit. Now, if that is the case, not only are you called according to purpose, but you are called into various offices. Various offices. You are not just called and left without an assignment to do. That is why the Bible says in Ephesians 4 verse 11 and 12, you are called to various offices. Work, some are called apostles, pastors, this and that. All of the fivefold ministry. You are called into various offices. There you can function and fulfill your purposes. Now hear this. People who are called are differently. Very many people are called very differently. For example, let me just give you one example. Some people are called within the spectacular, dramatical instances. People like Paul, who had an encounter with the Lord on his way to Damascus. It was practical, it was spectacular, it was dramatical. That you cannot deny. That is visible, tangible evidence that God had called that man of God. But there are others that are not so spectacular, but they are still called. You don't have to go through that. One person here is called through visions. Another person can be called through dreams. Another person can be called just by staying in the house of the Lord, like Samuel. Another person can be called by serving another man of God. Your calling can be released through that area. There are so many ways God calls people into action, into this ministry. Solomon, you remember, was called through dreams. God showed him, and then God called him and addressed him. So wherever your calling is, the man Elijah, the man Elijah, the prophet of fire, where most of us pray by thunder, by fire. Is that not so? By thunder, by fire. The prophet of fire. And then if you like, you join and put the name of Jesus. Here is the name of thunder. Here is the name of fire. And here is the name of Jesus placed together. But if I can read the whole thing, the name of Jesus is greater than everything else. So it's the name of Jesus I use. So I can't even direct God to answer me whether by fire or by thunder. He chooses how he answers me. Me is just to table my request to him. Now hear this. Elijah, the man of fire, the prophet of fire, was not called through fire. He was called through a small, still voice. All the drama happened, but God did not appear there. God did not speak there until when a small, still voice appeared. Then if that is the case, if you are called, any one of us here, whether we wear the collar or we don't, whether we have some extra titles or we don't have, hear this and understand this. Your being of call, your being called by God means, number one, that God has recognized you. God has identified you. God has chosen you. It doesn't matter whether a man agrees or he does not agree. It doesn't matter whether a man accepts it or he does not accept. Once it is God who has called, the calling stands. God does not have to consult a man to ordain another man. It is man that consults God. Hear me and hear me properly. If you are identified by God, chosen by God, selected by God, brought and appointed by God, then man must hands off over the work of God over your life. Thank you, sir. You didn't call me, God called me. Nahim Adesi. Thank you for holding my hands and holding my shoulder, but Nahim called me. And to him I shall give account. Now hear this. It means you are separated from your normalcy. You are brought into a place where supernatural occurrences should be happening in your life. Normalcy should not be the order of your day and life, but supernatural encounters happening in your life. May that be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Then if you are called and all these things happen, you must be sent out properly. And this is what we are going to do here tonight. Properly. All things must be done orderly, properly, correctly, and scripturally. If you understand that, you must also know that today you're receiving an office. You're receiving grace, you're receiving an office. If you know all these things, then the next thing that you should remember at the back of your spirit is that number one, everybody say number one, be humble. Sorry, sir. You must be humble. Everybody hit somebody and say humble. If you see a man falling, check out there is a haughty or a proud spirit. Before every exaltation, there must be. And before every fall, there must be. Now hear this properly. The fact that you are called by God, the fact that you have an office, the fact that you are appointed by God, the fact that you do the work of God, does not mean you should look down on the people of God. It's an honor, but it's not a place where you load it on the people of God. It's a place where you will serve God through the people in the humility of the Spirit. Be humble. Peter talks about it. James talks about it. Philippians talks about that too much. Then number two, everybody say number two. Look unto God and not unto man. What did I say, friends? The Bible says looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Man did not give you this job. God did. Look unto him. In your limitations, look unto him. In your successes, look unto him. Man may be there to give you a pat on the shoulder, but man is not the ultimate when it comes to ministry. Now, number three. Recognize that in spite of the fact that you are called by God, you still have limitations. You must understand it. In as much as you are a spirit being, you are also a fleshly being. You must understand and know that if I slap you as a man of God, you will feel the pain. If I slight you as a man of God, you will feel the pain. That makes you human. If I say something bad about you, as a man of God, you will feel the pain. Even if you do not react, but you will feel the pain. Listen carefully and hear me. Because you are a man of God, you do not have the answers to everything. First, I say you must be humble. Humility is the groundwork within which you will relate to humanity. Second position. Now the third one, I mean. Recognize the fact that you have limitations in as much as you need another person to help you make it. Are you hearing me? You need me, I need you. Nobody can stand in isolation and make this work fit. There is no hero of this work amongst us. Only Jesus Christ. And all of us, whatever title we have and have, we all honor the Lord Jesus Christ. There is no man that will all appear before God, and then you, the big boy or the head boy, will come and we'll bow down to the Lordship of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now the last, if you understand that you have limitation, please learn to bear with yourself. Because there are sometimes we overjudge ourselves. We overestimate ourselves. We feel we are the superhumans of every race. We can do everything. That's correct. That's what Christ said. But listen carefully. The reason why you have pastors amongst you, some people around you, is to help make the ministry full. You can't do everything yourself. So recognize the limitations of other people. Just like you have limitations, other people around you also have limitations. As you bear with yourself, learn also to bear with other people. This work cannot be done in the flesh. It can only be done in the spirit. Work on yourself. After you have looked to God, see your limitations. Don't dwell on your limitations. Understand the limitations of other people and help them overcome those limitations. That is ministry in its finest order. When I stand to speak against you and you stand against me, it's not our ministries we're doing. We have slipped and entered into the ministry of the devil. Because there we are not building up, we are tearing down. May God help us not to tear down the body of Christ, which is not your body. It is the body of Christ. When we fight and slight each other, hear me, my understanding of scriptures is not your understanding of scripture. Your understanding is his own. Don't look down on me because today you see me. Don't relegate me to the background because my destiny is not in your definition of who you see me. And then lastly, to all of you who are here, witnesses and pastors, I say this. Do not allow yourselves to be replaced by another person for the work of ministry, for the service of God. A sower sowed the seed, some fell by the wayside. They never amounted to anything. Jesus coming into Jerusalem, people were shouting, Hosanna, glory. And the man of letters and powers and titles said, tell these people to keep quiet. Jesus said, if these people should quit quiet, stones shall rise in their place. Do not allow stones to replace you. Don't allow stones to replace any one of you, men of God. Let's join our hands together, walk together, and bring about the mind of God for this generation. Thank you, and God bless you.